previously in Manehattan. For the sake of Javolt's science-based TV show, several kids from Cup of Sunshine's class, and one from a much higher grade, were invited down to a demolition site to talk about the science of explosions or something. Needless to say, things went wrong, and several of the kids got lost exploring the dilapidated building that was apparently constructed in the manner of RPG tropes, complete with trapdoors and treasure. An accident occurred, and the kids and adults barely had enough time to get out before the demolition began. Fortunately, no pony was harmed, but the kids were immediately sent back home, hopefully having learned a thing or two in the process. It's been, let's say, most of a week since that little incident. I imagine there was a prolonged conversation between the parents of those kids and the network, and either there's still a suit in progress or they've managed to settle that. That's not really it's not really what we're gonna focus on today. Zenkarn.
Yep.
Today is kind of a minor holiday. The schools are closed, but you know, you and Aurelia are still putting time in at the agency, the literary agency you both work at.
Because, you know, we both like getting paid.
That is very true. Although, on this particular day, you notice that Aurelia seems to be particularly anxious to finish her work. And actually, during your lunch conversation, it sounds like she's actually going to kind of clock out early. Because she has some kind of prior engagement.
Okay. While we're working, I'm signing papers or whatever. I sort of glance over and be like, so, not like you to leave early.
I know. You know, it's a thing I have to do back, you know, home, so.
Just a thing, huh?
A thing, yeah.
And anything cool?
I wouldn't say it's very cool, but you didn't hear that from me.
Oh, okay, well, you know, now I'm interested. Come on, spill.
I'd really rather,
Come on. Look, you can tell me now, or you can have me annoying you about it for the next 2 weeks. Your choice.
And you would, too, for precisely 14 days.
Yep.
Well, 10 business days. Anyway,
I don't know, I'd get to you on weekends.
Yeah. Alright, she kind of gestures for you to come closer.
I lean in.
She then kind of points out the window where the sun is kind of beating down on the city of Manhattan and says, "So it's a kind of a hot day today, right? Right? Like really hot."
Yeah.
I mean, for ponies anyway, not so much for dragons, but
yeah, I guess. Well, I mean, it gets like that.
So, see, now I don't want to tell you because you're not gonna
get
it.
Just look. Tell me, and then we can move on.
I heard that on days like this, ponies my age like to set up lemonade stands or something. And I'm gonna try that.
So you're going into your own business then, huh?
Not really a business, just sort of a, you know, kid thing. I didn't really get all the details, but apparently there's lemonade, there's ice, and you sell it for a cheap price, and, you know, get some pocket change, whatever.
I'm gonna regret this. Look over at, like, the work, look back at Aurelia, look at work, look at Aurelia. Okay, I'm in. Do you want a hand?
No, I'm good. I don't need any extra probes on this. I'm sure I'll do fine by myself. And she looks at the clock and says, "Oh, look at the time!" She stacks up all her papers and starts sets them on where they need to be delivered and then starts rushing out.
Hey, one thing before you leave.
What?
Where are you setting up so I can come over and get some after work?
Outside the boarding house, you know, my place.
Alright, I'll see you then soon. We don't have that much to finish up. Have fun.
Alright. And she rushes off. So, what are your plans after, you get your work done, Zenkar?
Probably go home, pick up some of the spare change, and go annoy Aurelia.
Alright. You make your way over to Manehattan's sort of dragon town. Basically the district of the city where there's a lot of dragon homes and businesses. And you head down the streets. You've probably been down before at this point, visiting Aurelia before, and there's this sort of kind of duplex kind of building. And out on the street in front of it, you see a table that has been set out, and sitting behind that table on a stool is the little black and gold baby dragon. There is a pitcher, a stack of plastic cups, and a sign in front saying, "Ice cold lemonade, 10 bits.
10 bits? That ain't cheap.
She notices you as you start coming down the street and just kind of grimaces to herself as you approach.
Look it all over and be like, "Apart from charging people a fortune, how's it going?"
She kind of looks forlornly at one cup she has set aside for, you know, where she's supposed to be collecting her money, and it's empty. And she says, "Not great."
What would I have to roll to actually know how much lemonade would normally be sold for?
That's probably general knowledge. That's if there was a stat called common sense, it'd probably be that.
Fair.
Look, how is a dragon supposed to start her hoard on a mere bit?
I don't know. Work it out. Hopefully that works. 26.
Oh, yeah. It's, you know, depending on the kids, depending on the lemonade stand, but usually the most commonly known price is like 2 bits.
Okay. So I look at her earlier and I'm like, "Okay, you sure you don't want any help?"
"I'm sure."
"Okay."
"Not from you or any of my dumb classmates either."
"All right, no help, but word of advice, a couple of kids selling it down the street for like less than half what you're charging."
"Really?
Yep.
That's why I'm not..."
"Yep."
"Okay." She kind of sadly hops off the stool, and grabs a marker, and goes to the front of the sign.
"You're probably looking for... Look, I think they're selling it for, like, 2, so if 2? You sell it for 1, you should be able to undercut most of their business."
"But...
You're a kid running a lemonade stand. No one's gonna give you large amounts of money. I'm sorry, that's the way the world works."
"But I kinda need the money, though."
"You have an actual job. What do you need money for?"
"Most of my paycheck goes towards..." She gestures at the building.
Perception. Should I roll perception to see what kind of repair the building's in?
Sure.
16!
Can tell the building's not, you know, not in any sort of bad way. It looks pretty normal, but it definitely looks very old.
Would I roughly know how much she's getting paid?
I mean, it's not terrible. Maybe, like, based on her hours and her job, like, pretty much only, like, half as much as you are.
Oh.
I mean, she is still a kid. But, I mean, which is still pretty good for the job, but...
Yeah, no, definitely. Alright. I'll look at the building, I'll look back to her, and I'll be like, "Okay, but..."
"I'm not doing this for that," she says, pointing to the lemonade stand, then for the building. "This is for a different thing."
"What thing?"
I'm not telling you everything. You don't get to, look, you don't get to run my life.
I am not running your life. All I'm saying is if you need money that desperately...
I don't want anyone's help on this.
Look, what are you trying to do?
Just...
At least tell me that.
I'm trying to send a package back home.
Oh. Sure. Okay.
Which is, considering how far that is, that's expensive.
Yeah, I can imagine. I'll dip in to, you know, whatever I use as a money holder. Probably just into a pocket in the suit and drop, like, 4 bits into the cup. And I'll be like, "I'll take 1.
She kind of frowns at her sign, scratches out the 10 and writes 2. You want 2 cups?
Nah, just 1. Extra 2 can be a tip.
She pours you 2 plastic cups full of ice cold lemonade.
Fine. I'll take 1. Just sit down next to it. Drink it. Be like, so, how long have you had this plan in the works?
Like 3 days.
Right. Got any plans for, attracting more customers than me?
Not just... I thought, you know, kids just set it up and it just kind of worked.
Yeah, I wish. Okay. Remember the kids down the street I was telling you about?
They're not actually down there, are they?
Well, I mean, not down that street, but that's not the point. The point is, they were trying to be a little bit more proactive with the people walking past.
What, you just want me to shout at people in this neighborhood?
Not shout at people, but you need to convince them. You know, like you'd convince the clientele at, you know, our actual job to either sign or give up on their hopes and dreams.
Yeah, but
you need to do the same type of thing here, but for lemonade.
But how do you... I don't know. This was all just a terrible idea. She starts, you know, just kind of stares at the lemonade, just like, she looks like she's about to just pack it all up and head back inside.
Ah, come on. Alright, perception to see people walking past, I guess. See if there's anyone who looks a, not rich, but looks like a sucker, basically.
You're in kind of, in deep into Dragon Town. The dragons around here are kind of harder to read than ponies.
Damn. Wait.
And none of them look super affluent.
Would that be an insight check?
Insight, yeah.
Okay. I'll make an insight check, sure. I get a 15 bonus to that, why not? Let's crit fail. It'll be hilarious. Woohoo!
You actually crit fail. You have no idea. Like, you thought that you've been able to read Aurelia so well that you could just, you know, read dragons as well as you can read ponies, but you actually, like, their expressions and mannerisms are completely alien to you. You have no idea who's rich, who's poor, who's happy, who's sad, who's, you know, who's even looking where. You just are just utterly confused by the information you're getting.
Okay. New plan. Selling lemonade to dragons, probably not a great idea. Selling lemonade to ponies, probably far easier. Your business model isn't wrong, you've just set it up in the wrong place.
So where do I go? And would ponies accept lemonade from a dragon?
Sure. I mean, how many ponies actually deal with dragons on a day-to-day basis? I bet most of them would be interested just to talk to you. And
yeah, that much I gathered from the classes.
Yeah, exactly. See, the kids will all come up because they want to hang out with the dragon, which means the parents will come up and give you money. Easy sold.
All right, Mr. Expert, where do I go?
We don't want to go near to any of the residential districts because I bet too many kids will set that up. Why don't we go do it, you know that little park near the company? If we set it up in there, there should be, should be plenty of people going through there at this time of day.
Alright. She starts packing up the lemonade and ice into a cooler that she has set aside. And then...
I'll give her a hoof just with packing it all up.
She then runs into the house and shouts up, "Hey, Ironside, I'm heading to the park with Zenkarn. See you later." And then she heads back down the stairs and hefts up the cooler and says, "All right, let's go."
Okay. And grab anything she hasn't.
The table and the sign, basically.
Yeah, I can carry that.
All right, so the two of you head over to basically the park that's kind of close-ish to the agency where you both work. And there's a bunch of ponies kind of playing there in the park right now. There's a sort of water feature nearby that a bunch of families have gathered around to play and to cool off and basically try to make the most of the weather, even though it's, you know, It's just really, really hot out. And you find a spot near one of the benches, and Aurelia says, this looks, I guess, a pretty good place. It's kind of out of the way, not really in any sort of central location, but it seems like she doesn't want to get too close to the other ponies.
Hmm. Yeah, they should be able to see us from here. Should work. Sorry.
So you and her kind of set up the table with the revised sign, and she plops down on her stool and just kind of looks around and waits.
What was that conversation before?
I don't want to shout it.
Come on. Look adorable, and they'll give you money.
No.
Come on.
I hate looking cute, and you know that.
I know, but it's so effective. You are so adorable. And I give her a little head pat.
At this point, I'm going to kind of open the floor and say, at this point, any of the other characters can just happen by the lemonade stand as this is going on. You know, just by sheer coincidence.
Wink, wink, nudge, nudge, say no more.
And anyone else want to, or shall I?
By all means, just jump in.
Okay. Can I say Sweet Cake is out with, I'll probably say not with Pop Rocks since Powder Cake isn't here yet, but maybe out with Golden Crown and Mort?
Sure.
And they will kind of happen in the vicinity. Oh, hey, new kid.
Of course, the first customer I get is... Oh, wait, sorry. Hey, ponies, you want some ice cold lemonade? Here you go.
Is everything okay? You hate interacting with people.
Everything's fine, Sweet Cake.
She looks expectantly at Zenkarn.
I just shrug. Something to do with money in a package. Just don't question it and embrace the non-abuse.
Embrace the what?
Embrace the non-abuse. Just go with
it. The non-abuse.
She'll just kind of go, okay. And she'll look at the sign, hand over a couple of bits.
Aurelia's eyes, well, she looks very sort of awkward and angry about this whole thing. Her eyes do light up a bit when you drop a couple of bits in this cup she has labeled money. And she pours you a glass of ice-cold lemonade.
Sweet Cake
will take... Not a glass, a plastic cup.
Plastic cup. Sweet Cake will take a taste of it. What is it like?
It is basically your basic grocery store lemonade. It is perfectly fine.
That's nice. You make it yourself?
No. How does a pony even make lemonade yourself?
With lemons.
With lemons?
And sugar.
You make lemonade out of lemons?
What?
Is that... She looks at Zenkarn and is like, is that a thing ponies do?
What has she been learning?
Stop breaking the dragon, please. Please stop breaking the dragon.
But why?
No, if you squeeze it yourself, you can probably charge more for it.
She gets kind of a... she gets kind of an evil look in her eye at that. She's like, really? Don't say. So wait, that would be work, wouldn't it?
Think about it this way. Yes, you could probably charge a bit or two more, Aurelia, but you'd have to buy the lemons first. And that's more work than you're willing to put in.
Yeah.
I know you're...
We kind of got a lot of lemons just kind of hanging around at home. My folks like to have them with their adult drinks.
That was amazing. Okay.
Thank you. I could grab a bag for you. You'll never miss them.
Okay, but how do you actually make the lemonade from the lemons?
Well, you get a squeezer, and then I think you add water, and I don't know what's happened to Sweet Cake's accent this week, by the way, and lots of sugar. At least I make it with lots of sugar.
You know how to make... Okay, I wouldn't be able to cut you in or anything, because I need the money for a thing, but could you help me out, maybe? This is not going well.
Yeah, give it some time. You know, I know you're not much of a pony dragon, but if you kind of, like, open up to people a bit more and, like, use that dragon charm, you do have... You know what? Don't answer that question. But, you know, you could, like, try to sell it a bit more and...
I'm already trying to sell it. I have a sign that says ice cold lemonade, 2 bits.
See? Listen to the child. The child is saying what I said. Listen to the child.
You know, like, sort of smiling at people and going, oh, sure is a hot day. You want some lemonade? That kind of thing. Look, you wait here and see what you can do. I'm going to run home. Hey, you guys, you're going to help me take stuff here, right? She just kind of...
Morton.
Is kind of roping the other two into it.
Golden Crown really does not look like Golden Crown looks like there's other stuff she wanted to do today. Mort's actually totally interested in this, though.
Cutie Mark Crusaders Lemon Gatherers? I don't know.
Golden Crown looks to you, then looks to Mort, and looks to Aurelia, and rolls her eyes and says, oh, all right.
Come on, we can carry...
But the next thing we do has to be super awesome to make up for it.
Okay, well, yeah, obviously, but not getting blown up again, because that wasn't fun.
Really? Because I had this idea, I heard... And she, in this conversation...
And with that, they just kind of start walking off.
Yeah, exactly. All right. Aurelia takes a deep breath and stretches out her cheeks and puts on the most sickeningly saccharine smile she can possibly manage and just starts beaming at all the ponies who walk by, almost kind of in a creepy way.
No, Aurelia... Adorable, remember?
But she said smile.
Yeah, you're not so great at smiling. Just look cute and offer lemonade to people. All you've got to do.
She makes an attempt, but the best she can seem to manage is this sort of grumpy cute.
Eh, close enough.
Okay, I just rolled.
Monitor rolls a 20 for stuff to appear from nowhere. You are very close to the lemonade stand and currently unnoticed. How do you decide to appear?
Monitor walks up to Aurelia and says, and she sort of reaches out a hoof and starts adjusting the smile.
Ah! Okay.
You were smiling with the wrong muscle groups. Those are the predatory muscle groups. You want to smile with these muscles. She's sort of tapping Aurelia's face as she's explaining.
Someone in the chat asks, what is Monitor in this story? Maybe you want to clarify real quick?
Monitor is an earth pony wearing a... Well, there's a long name for it, but it's shortened down to Music Box. The Music Box... is how she talks, because her throat has a number of burn marks.
Ah, right.
Also, she's Javolt's adopted daughter, so...
Alright. Aurelia just looks utterly weirded out by you, and just... Where did... Your monitor, right? Or something?
Yes.
Where did you come from?
That is a very long story.
She just kind of looks around and says, but this is a park. Surely you can't.
Oh, you mean where did I come from today?
Right. How did you? You know what? Never mind. Sure. I'll take your advice. Great. Thanks. And she swivels back on her stool to smile at ponies again.
Is she smiling any differently or?
Not really. No.
Monitor swivels Aurelia back and says, "You're showing too much teeth. You're scaring them off. You have to be friendly."
I really wish I didn't know what that word meant. Alright. She takes another long breath, and then actually puts on a kind of pleasant smile. Not showing too much teeth, just generally looking very friendly and approachable. Although, based on how rigid she is, you can definitely tell that it's just an act.
Monitor smiles, swivels her back, and then starts sort of puts a hoof on her shoulder and starts sort of casually massaging it.
Stop touching me. Stop.
Contact is normal for ponies.
Well, relaxation comes from contact. Not normal for dragons. Go.
You are attempting to sell to ponies, correct?
Yeah.
Appeal to the part of ponies that is the part of ponies. Appeal to their core instincts, and they will be appealed to you. Feel as though you are young, and they will feel as though they must support.
You are weirding me out right now.
It's the box. It doesn't work ever. Often. Sometimes wrong words. Confusing.
Also, the touching shoulders. Off! Off with you!
And she retracts her hoof and sighs.
Okay. Just, you know, I get that, you know, you're in a weird situation, but, you know, Zenkarn, can you help me out here?
Got a point.
What point?
You need to be more approachable.
I'm here. How am I making approaching difficult?
I don't know. Wave. Interact a little bit more.
She waves at one of the ponies passing by, who just kind of chuckles at the lemonade stand, but does not approach to buy any lemonade.
You're not going to get them all?
She continues to try waving down pony after pony until finally one of them walks up and says, oh, that sounds nice, actually. It's, been on a long jog. Yeah, I'll get a cup. And, she drops a couple of bits in the cup, and, Aurelia pours out a glass of lemonade. And then the pony is on his way. Aurelia just kind of looks surprised at the whole process.
Is that really so difficult?
Well, apparently.
All you had to do was wave and not grouch at people.
But that's way harder than it sounds.
You'll do fine.
All right. Got the routine down. And so many, many minutes pass as she starts interacting more with the ponies in the park. Just, you know, smiling at them, waving at them when they pass by. And occasionally, every so often, making a sale. You know, pouring out some lemonade here and there. And Aurelia's mood seems to be lifted. Until she starts to realize that there's a small problem. In that her pitcher is about to run out, and she does not seem to have much more.
You have more of a resupply in the cooler, right?
Conveniently timed return of the Cutie Mark Crusaders?
She opens up the cooler and there's not a whole lot else in there.
And it's actually just shortcake with lemons.
There's just a bag that seems to be with some snacks in it for her. And she says, this is Ironside's cooler and I didn't really have enough to buy more, so.
I wonder if she broke even.
How much did you need to make exactly?
It was like 80 plus tax, so like 85, 86, something.
And looking over how much has she made so far?
Between you and all the other customers, like 14.
Okay, we've got a long way to go. Cool. I'll start looking up and down, seeing if Shortcake's got back yet.
Shortcake?
Sweet cake.
Who are you calling short?
You! Stop being tiny and everything.
There's someone echoing.
Oh god, I hope it's not me.
It was a very faint echo. Anyway, not going to dwell on it until culprit comes out. Yeah, a little while after Aurelia starts panicking, and she does manage to sell another cup in the meantime, but now it's like there's almost nothing left in the pitcher. And it's at this point that Sweetcake and her friends come on back.
Okay, so Sweetcake has kind of a bulging saddlebag on either side of her back, and behind her, Mort and Golden Crown are carrying quite a large bottle, one of those kind of, a bit like one of those basically the water you buy in bulk in the store, bottled water.
Yeah.
Their telekinesis between them.
All right. And Aurelia just kind of looks at you guys with a sort of confused expression going, so is that all the stuff you were getting?
Yeah, we've got water, and I've got, she starts unpacking onto her little stall, lemons, there's a kind of grocery bag full of lemons, sugar, and she holds out a bag of castor sugar, and a pitcher.
How big is this grocery bag of lemons? Is this a plastic grocery bag or one of the cloth grocery bags?
I'm going to say plastic grocery bag, just like when you go to the shop and you get a bag.
Hmm.
And then she kind of, out of the other saddlebag, she kind of pulls out a large plastic pitcher and a knife for cutting the lemons. I know you already got a pitcher, but I figured it might couldn't hurt to have another one.
Okay. She takes one of the lemons out of the bag and kind of hefts it in her claw and says, so this makes lemonade, huh? That's what every pony's been drinking.
Pretty much. I mean, you know, don't try and eat it like it is, though. It's really, really... You need sugar with it.
Okay.
It is not the lemon of itself that creates the lemonade. It is the essence.
Oh, hi, Monitor. When did you get here?
A while in past. Monitor actually frowns and taps at her box.
Is your music box acting up today?
Yes, it is the warm.
Huh, I didn't know that. She also puts a lemonade squeezer on the stall. So you cut them in half, and then, well, do you want me to show you?
Yeah, if you could.
Well, she looks very slightly pleased about getting to use a knife.
Monitor very carefully and subtly sidesteps away.
So, sorry, I've just shifted. Can you still hear me okay?
Yeah.
Okay. So, she kind of, I think she probably didn't have the foresight to bring a chopping board. So she just kind of, holds it in place. Actually, she's going to ask, Mort to hold it in place with his telekinesis. And, she cuts it in half. And then, takes one of the halves and starts squeezing it on the juicer. You see the juice coming out of it? You want to try? She kind of pushes the squeezer in her direction.
All right. She hesitantly starts, you know, taking one of the lemon halves and just kind of jamming it onto the juicer.
You kind of gotta turn it a bit.
She does so, getting some juice here and there.
And make sure you don't do it too fast, or the juice will go everywhere. You want it to kind of collect in this bit here, see? She gestures.
All right. She does this for a little while, and then out of nowhere, she goes, achoo! And
what?
A small ember gets onto the juicer onto the lemon she was squeezing out, and it actually catches fire.
All right, hold on.
And she, just startled by this, she just flings it over the table and onto the pavement of the walkway.
Sweet Cake just kind of blinks and goes, okay, so combustible lemons.
I did not realize lemons were combustible. That's good to know.
They should not be combustible. Dragon magic is weird.
Yeah.
Let's call that one just a test lemon, but we're not going to use that one now.
Yeah. Would a lemon count as a failure?
What are you rolling?
Oh, rolling, there's something else.
Down the fire.
Actually, Aurelia, can you, like, control your fire?
Oh, yeah, most of the time, just not when I'm surprised, like that.
Sweet! No, that's really good, because...
If anyone's looking at Monitor, they might notice that she's silently hyperventilating.
Ooh, can I roll perception in that case?
You roll will to not freak out at the fire. You manage to control yourself.
you have to remember she survived the fire, so.
Yeah.
I did not remember that. Remember, this is a new timeline.
Sorry. I put that on the consolidation dock under the characters. I don't think... Did you look at the consolidation dock?
I have no chance
to check.
You
might have missed that message.
Dang it.
Anyway.
Ow.
No, he didn't. He put Aurelia on the dock.
I just didn't check everything on it.
Sorry.
Weaver still mentioned it a few minutes ago when he was describing the music box, but yeah.
He mentioned the burns, yeah. I got a 22. Would I notice anything?
Yeah, you noticed that between her reactions to the knife and to the fire, just in some, you know, in small, subtle ways, Marta does seem to be a bit bothered.
So, in the middle of kind of talking to Aurelia, so Sweetcake's kind of like, see, I was thinking of, Monitor, you okay over there?
Monitor actually takes a moment to hold her music box and sort of shuts her eyes and takes a breath, lets it out, and says, just past image is past. And then she frowns and she taps her box again, and I am in good now.
Flotsam's eyes dart from Monitor to the lemon, and she just kind of nudges Mort and says, psst, put out the fire. And she kind of twists the top off the bottle of water.
Oh, Mort takes the bottle and just kind of pours it onto the, not really on fire, but now just sort of smoldering lemon.
Combustible lemon, what?
Aurelia kind of rolls her eyes at Monitor and says, if you're not okay with a little bit of fire now and then, we're not going to get along, gotta say.
I am fine with controlled fire blame, fire burst, fire controlled fire.
Doesn't seem Monitor. Like you were, because that's about as bad as it gets as far as accidents go for me. Now you should see my aunts and uncles back home. Yeah, that'd be something to be scared about.
Monitor just, her eyes just snap wide and she freezes.
New kid, sometimes you gotta pay attention to how other folks are reacting.
Now I see it. Just trying to help her toughen up.
And con't face
this ain't something you toughen up over that quick. Cut her some slack.
Alright, I'm sorry.
Hey, so, Monitor... controlled fires are okay. So, see, I was thinking, I know. She kind of, retrieves the, lemon juice squeezer, and kind of just shakes it off, and, passes it over to Monitor with the other half of lemon. How about you squeeze that, and Aurelia, usually it works better, if the sugar is kind of like melted into the water, so maybe if we put the sugar in the water and then you can heat it up, and then the sugar won't sink to the bottom.
But then we put ice in it, right? Because I don't think anyone wants warm lemonade.
Ice! I knew I'd forgotten something.
You didn't get more ice?
Oh, I thought you had ice.
Monitor actually raises a hoof and says, my father actually prefers steamed lemonade in cold winter.
It's a hot spring day. Really hot spring day.
We should bear that in mind for winter, though.
Look, if I go and buy ice, will you kids be okay here by yourselves?
Monitor actually looks at Zenkarn and then puts a hoof to her forehead and says, right, you were not here at the explosion.
That does not fill me with confidence.
Sweet Kate just smiles innocently.
I am opening the floor again for one of the other players to jump in with their characters.
Please help, I need an adult. And not a, like, cool adult. I need a responsible adult who wouldn't let children play with knives.
Suddenly, Minotaur...
Using a knife?
That might be a good idea, a good time for Brass Knuckles to wander on by.
Patrolling the park.
Well, actually, I'm imagining he's got a number of empty, sip to dry plastic cups on his horns, like he's been to a number of lemonade stands in town already.
he's doing the rounds. He knows that all the kids will be out today.
He's a connoisseur.
And he's giving him a little hand by stopping by and checking in. And
that's... when I was your age, I used to sell lemonade too.
All right. I will allow this, that you...
It was a much harder business back then, because we hadn't found lemons yet.
Great. If I see... Tempid, what's your character's name again?
Brass Knuckles.
Brass Knuckles.
Thank you.
Brass Knuckles comes
brass
by
something.
Somehow brimming with recently drunk plastic cups.
Well, no, I mean, he's been collecting them on his horn as he's gone through the day, so.
Yes.
Great.
Adorned with plastic cups.
I look over at Brass Knuckles, and I'm like, you! I remember you! You were from Korea Day. Come here for a sec, I need a hand.
Yes, hello, yes, I recognize you as well. How is it going?
Not too bad. Do you reckon you could stay here for, like, 5 minutes tops and make sure this lot doesn't get into any big amounts of trouble? Please? I need to go buy ice for the dragon.
Brass Knuckles looks over the group, he immediately recognizes some of them, and looks back to Zenkarn.
Well, I'll see what I can do, but with this little company, I can't make any promises.
Just don't let them do anything crazy with the knives until I get back, okay? Great, thanks. And I'll go off to go find ice.
And he's off.
Well, hello there.
Greetings to... you.
Flotsam hides the knife.
Hello,
where does
officer.
She hide the knife?
Under the stall.
Okay.
And I mean sweet cake, damn it.
Shortcake, damn you.
I am not a shortcake.
That doesn't look like very safe knife handling.
Yeah, I can tell you that, yeah.
So, trying the little lemonade stand business, eh?
Yeah, are those plastic cups on your horns?
Yeah. Yes, they are.
Why?
Because I've been going to various lemonade stands around town.
There's a bunch of them?
And your horns have been drinking the lemonade?
No, I've been drinking the lemonade. I've just been storing the cups on my horns once I'm done with it.
What use purpose?
What?
For cups, what purpose do you have for continued storage?
Honestly, none whatsoever.
So there is literally no reason why you are keeping the lemonade cups and storing them on your horns.
He can always wash them inside his own lemonade stand.
Well, not that they have, not now that they have holes in them.
No.
So, you trying to... So, what do you have here?
Like one glass of worth of ice cold lemonade left for 2 bits a cup, and then a whole bunch of lemons and water and sugar and no ice.
He looks at the sign and the way it's been. How well is the original price left visible?
Still fairly visible underneath all the marker scribbles.
Oh, it looks like you really cut down on the price.
I didn't really do my market research.
Well, that price, I oughta charge you for highway robbery. Just a joke.
Aurelia doesn't laugh at all.
Monitor has started chopping and chopping and what do you call that with the lemons? What's it called?
Squeezing?
The squeezer? Juicer?
Yeah,
thing.
Chop, squeeze...
Juicing the lemon.
Juice. And she's basically putting this in one of the pitchers, all the juice from there.
The productive
one of the
empty member
pitchers.
Of our team.
Uh-huh. The one who's actually...
Until it's at least half full. And she sort of gives Aurelia a look and nudges her and points at the sugar in the water.
Oh, all right. She starts to mix the sugar into the water, and with very, very tiny embers at a time, starts to heat up the pitcher.
Sweet cake supervises how much sugar goes in. It is quite a lot.
Monitor actually seems to disagree with Sweet Cake's choice, but because she actually shakes her head at Aurelia when Sweet Cake says this much, and she sort of says not that much. But you know, without actually saying anything.
I'm confused, but okay. I think Sweet Cake will probably put in way too much sugar regardless.
Well, Brass Knuckles will tell them to make sure this is keeping safe, especially with the fire going off now.
You definitely have the authority to supervise and make sure it all is handled safely. Although the table beneath him starts getting a little bit singed by the embers.
I want to be careful you don't burn up your table.
Oh, yeah. Should have brought, like...
Quick question. Are we on the grass right now, or is there, like, a little path?
Yeah, there's a path. You're kind of next to the benches and whatnot. She's set up on one of the concrete or stone paths of the park.
Cool. Well, we could always put it on the ground. Like, the pitcher. Not the water.
Right, okay. And she moves the pitcher down to the ground.
And is that okay, Officer Knuckles? Or is that damaging property or something?
They did. Are they doing anything that looks like a damaging property?
Other than, you know, a few embers spilling off onto the stone, not really. They're far away from. They've kind of set up in the middle. They're far away from the.
This is just like stone walkway, right?
Yeah.
I don't think that should be.
No, that looks like it should be good.
Oh, good.
All right. Slowly but surely, the sort of handmade lemonade starts to come together. Although you're still lacking ice, but you have kind of drawn a bit of a spectacle as a few ponies kind of just hang out in the park regardless, seem to have caught notice that you guys are going to all this effort to hoof, squeeze, and mix together lemonade yourselves.
Sweet Cake notices. Can I actually... Sweet Cake is just going to nudge... I'm going to position Sweet Cake in between Aurelia and Monitor, and she's just going to nudge both of them and nod in the direction, and then just kind of smile her sweetest smile at the onlookers. Hiya!
The onlookers, you seem to have their full attention.
Ow.
We sure hope we're not in the way here or anything.
You kind of are, but no one seems to mind.
Smile, smile, blink, blink.
Some of them express interest, wondering when the lemonade's going to be ready.
Well, we've had such high demand that unfortunately we run out of ice, but we'll be getting some very shortly.
Alright, some of them leave to go back to their activities in the park, and a couple actually stick around, waiting patiently, making conversation amongst themselves, etc.
Hey, not bad. Guess they appreciate a little effort, huh?
At this point, if you are ready, Din, your character can come by if you want her to.
I think so. Everything else I'm adding at this point is just kind of for flavor.
All right.
So let me get that character sheet over to you guys. There we go. Anyways, yes, at this point, Cup of Sunshine will be walking through the park with an iced coffee and a book. And despite having been very invested in said book up until a moment ago, she will turn and see the sort of commotion and walk towards it.
You notice Officer Brass Knuckles and a few students you recognize from your class, they seem to be hand-making lemonade for a lemonade stand. They've bought a bunch of lemons and sugar and water and are, like, manually mixing them together.
Kappa is going to look from the kids to Brass Knuckles, then back to the kids, then back to Brass Knuckles, before sort of sidling over and, sidling over to the kids and, whispering,
"So, what exactly did you do to get the police on you to make lemonade?"
"He is not acting in of legal operations. His job is currently inactive."
"Well, hello there."
"Hi, hello. Good to see you again, Officer Knuckles."
"Yes, how is your day going?"
Just fine. Just went to get some coffee and a book."
"Going sounds good."
Monitor is going to try to subtly catch the title of the book.
The book is actually quite visibly the title is notably not in Equestrian. It is in Draconic script.
Ooh.
Aurelia takes a look at that book title.
Aurelia can tell that it is actually one of those Harlequin romance novels just written by a dragon.
Aurelia,
what would I have to roll to say that Monitor knows Draconic?
Nothing, because the answer is no.
Well, she's the child of a famous scholar.
Yeah, so you get, you know, a magic box that can allow a mute to speak, but not Draconic knowledge of the language.
Dang it.
That boon only goes so far. You can certainly study it later, if you are now so inclined.
Monitor is the new temperate steel.
Access to the language materials is probably far more open in this particular timeline than in Fall of His Dragons. You could probably just get it done.
How many
sessions.
People said
50 shades of scales or 50 scales of gray? God damn it.
Everyone is saying 50 scales of gray all at once.
Holy crap, I forgot that was a thing.
Oh dear.
Aurelia, just for her part, is just kind of confused, and then suddenly she stops being a little kid, and her literary agent experience comes back, and she's like, oh, yeah, and then she goes back to heating up the water.
Kappa will blush and put the book into her saddlebag, having noticed that.
"Well, Draconic, that's impressive."
"I happen to be."
Wow, that can be taken so many different ways.
That was suddenly the best possible line, and I don't know why.
I'm not sure why either, but I loved it. Kappa will just sort of awkwardly shrug and then go, "Well, I mean, it's one of the many things I've tried to learn."
And, Monitor, can I roll insight to, or does Monitor just catch on to the subtext? Or?
Do you really want Monitor to be so aware of the material that her teacher is reading? Are you really that desperate to know?
I'm just going to roll insight for that.
Roll insight.
I wonder.
Monitor has theories as to what's going on, but she's not really sure of any of them.
Hmm.
She is DeVault's child, so I'm thinking she's theorizing that there's something going on between Knuckles and Kappa.
She's more
there wasn't
that,
before.
Kappa might.
Yeah, there.
Well, given Kappa's particular choice in literature, she's more theorizing that Kappa is more attracted to more strong and possessive individuals. And
let's not go down this road.
This tangent has gone on long enough.
It's gone on in the conversation.
Thank you, Weaver, for gone in taking that across the finish line.
Oh!
They swear the whole draconic line.
Alright.
Was meant to be completely innocent.
By this point, mercifully, Zenkarn comes back.
And I'm not sure I want to be dragged into this, but...
Yeah, and then at that point, Monitor looks at Zenkarn and her eyes just widen. And she just sort of clears her
out of throat. It.
And she doesn't say anything.
Good.
She's not like Javolt that way. She just...
Yeah.
Only like Javolt in every other respect.
I just look at her earlier and I'm like, I got your eyes. Oh, hi, teacher lady.
Hello.
You notice that they've kind of, since they started working on the hoof-made juice, that they've attracted a bit of a crowd because they made it into such a production.
At this point, Kuppa will reach back into her saddlebags and pull out a few bits just to place into the cup.
But the lemonade's not quite ready yet.
There is no speed juice. And Monitor frowns and actually rolls her eyes and just points at the iced coffee. There is no speed juice.
There's no coffee. We're not selling lemonade. Coffee.
Yes. Thanks.
Kuppa is going to chuckle.
Aurelia holds back her laughter at the term speed juice.
Kuppa is going to laugh before going, oh, heavens no, coffee tastes absolutely terrible with lemonade. But I just figured I could prepay, make sure that I get a cup later.
Well, I mean, we've got the ice now. This is almost all mixed together.
Sweet Cake is just kind of looking at Kuppa, kind of goggle-eyed, and going, wait, you drink stuff other than coffee?
Kuppa will absolutely laugh at that. Just because I drink so much coffee doesn't mean I don't drink other things. Imagine drinking so much coffee. That'd probably kill me.
Yeah.
Monitor is going to roll to see if Kuppa has any undead nature around her.
What?
Can I roll Arcana for that?
Well, I'm confused.
Are you implying that she's a zombie powered by coffee? This is
Head
not
cannon.
Shantae.
I am not.
I'm going to roll Arcana.
No, you're not. You're not.
Arcane analysis for that.
You can imagine that you do, but that's not a valid roll in this.
I'm just going to see how much she misinterprets the situation. She got a 10.
You don't have that kind of magical ability at all. You may close your eyes and concentrate as hard as you possibly can, and then you realize, oh, wait, I have no idea what that would actually look like.
I do have arcane.
You don't need to.
Just check to see if she's numbing on people's brains. If she isn't, you're fine.
Situation.
You know what? A kid can have whatever headcanon they want for their teacher.
That's true.
So,
you can't summon the strength to analyze her in that respect, but you don't find any evidence to disprove it either.
So, yeah.
All right. So that's Monitor's interpretation.
In that moment, Monitor decides to swear off Marebucks forever.
Don't you see it's an industry to keep the zombies of our nation fueled forever? Boycott Starbucks.
It's an industry to create and then fuel the zombies.
It is secretly operated by Zenkarn's distant relative.
By Zenkarn's alternate reality self.
No, it's just...
No, it's just me. Everything else is just a front. That's actually my business.
Zenkarn, still a Lich Lord, just with coffee. Bit more subtle.
Okay, then.
By the way, while all the production has been going on with the lemonade making... can we possibly say that Mort has been kind of trying to help in a kind of awkwardly hovering kind of way, and Golden Crown has been supervising?
Yes, Mort has been trying to stay close to Aurelia, trying to help with whatever she's working on at the time. So he's stirring the water as she's heating it. Helping her mix the sugar and the lemons and the lemon juice in the water. And Aurelia seems to be making a concerted effort to sort of pretend that him being so close doesn't mean, you know, anything.
Oh my god, this is carrying on from the last session. I approve.
Sure is.
Just like, yeah, whatever, thanks.
Flotsam, noticing this, will give a little more space to the two of them, and will also quality test the sugar occasionally.
You, every so often you have a nip of processed sugar, and it is, in fact, sugar.
It is good. Just checking, it could have been contaminated by nature.
Yeah. Precisely, with Flotsam's rich actor and senator parent or senator parents, a scandal surely just waiting.
And then Flotsam was kidnapped.
This is a slice of life campaign, goddammit.
Kidnappings are slice of life. They happen.
Sure, okay, sorry. So is murder and fighting dragons, sure.
It's slice of life, and thus you take it off the rails, we must truly go out there.
Goodness.
She gets kidnapped, but she saves herself with a musical number.
Anyway.
That would be MLP appropriate.
At long last, the lemonade comes together. Aurelia plops back down into her stool with not one but two fresh pitchers of lemonade with the ice poured in to start chilling it, and says, "All right, now ready to start serving again. Thanks, every pony, for waiting, I guess." And there is a small, humble flurry of activity as ponies line up to, you know, drop a couple of bits into the cup, which is now starting to fill up with these gold bits now. And she just starts pouring cup after cup, and she looks to the others and says, "Keep making more, we might need more."
You guys handle that. I gotta go do something real quick. And she flies off.
Okay. Sweetcake leaves, and Mort and Golden Crown and Monitor, I suppose, help keep the process going as Aurelia takes on the role of the storefront.
Mm-hmm. Where Sweetcake is going, incidentally, is to round up the other ponies who were showing an interest earlier and let them know that the wait is over.
Ah. So, yeah, and I'd say... I guess roll perception to see if you can find more of those ponies again.
You bet. Oh, fiddly. Where's it gone? Right. D20 plus 9. That's an unnatural 20.
All right. Yeah, you're able to find just about every pony that you recognized from earlier that had wandered off before, and they seem, you know, one or two of them are like, oh, well, okay, sure. They don't seem like they're actually that interested. They were just kind of interested in novelty, but the rest are like, oh, great, cool, and they come on over, or at least promise to come on over at their earliest convenience, and you bring a few more ponies into the line this way.
Yes. She will smile sweetly at them and then go back to helping behind the stall.
All right. And Aurelia, at this point, just looks... She looks like she's trying not to be excited about all this, because finally... The cup that she set aside for the money is starting to overflow a bit. They had to get out a second cup. They're not terribly big, so.
Kappa will sneak a little bit behind the stand, see roughly how much they have left as far as supplies are concerned.
Let's see. Doing estimates in my head. As you're watching, they're doing pretty well, even though they're hand juicing everything. They start to optimize the process a bit. But it looks like that after this rush of customers comes through, they might end up being a little short.
In that case,
they'll be in danger at that point again. Because, mm-hmm. you know, hand juicing lemons, no matter, even if you got a bunch of them, is not going to produce that much.
Mm-hmm. Kappa's going to sneak off and, go purchase some more supplies, as well as pick something up from her house.
Okay.
Coffee! What?
Brass Knuckles is going to look at the size of the original cooler or container and see how it compares to the amount of bits she's earned.
Well, the cooler is fairly large, larger than even her initial supplies were.
I mean, is it presently empty?
Well, she's not putting the money in the cooler.
She's putting the money into just a couple of spare cups.
Well, I mean, are the supplies she brought with her, are they all out of it?
Yeah, they're all out of it. The cooler is empty right now, except for basically the spare ice and lemons and sugar they brought, you know, sweet cake brought back. They've been put into the cooler.
Ah, okay.
Sweet cake is definitely not still sneaking sugar. Definitely not.
Definitely not. Actually, roll stealth.
Yeah.
Roll stealth. If you roll a nat one, I'm just picturing sweet cake like just
sugar
hard lining sugar.
What the heck is my stealth anyway? 5. Oops. Not too bad.
Like I am talking Scarface levels of taking sugar.
22. You are a crafty little filly, and despite the crowd, no one really notices. Or if they do notice, they just find it too darn cute to care.
Yeah.
Evil little filly.
She's going to have all the cavities when she grows up.
Yeah.
They've got magic for that.
In the chat, hard lining sugar as alternate Tibbs wipes a tear away.
I would like to thank the chat, by the way, for suggesting that sweet cake start eating the sugar. Because she totally would.
All right. Goodness, where? Okay, so, let's see. So, Kuppa left a while back. Zenkarn's still around, right? Or?
Yeah.
Brass Knuckles is still around.
Brass Knuckles is present.
Sweet cake, yeah, and Monitor.
Yep.
As the crowd starts to die down and, you know, sales
Brass Knuckles has started playing a friendly little background tune.
What instrument does he carry around again?
The sitar.
The sitar.
It's the combination thing that I'm not really sure which.
It's a sitar.
It's a ukulele.
It's some kind of guitar, banjo, ukulele hybrid thingy.
It is a quantum stringed instrument. Anyway,
And for some reason, it sounds like a trumpet.
So anyway. That spectacle in and of itself actually draws in more customers. That is to say, a Minotaur police officer playing a little ditty on a lute or something. And then they notice that there's a baby dragoness running a lemonade stand. It's like, well, that's just too darn cute. And you get a few more sales that way.
And then he starts getting into it and just does a little tiny dance to go with it.
And Monitor actually sort of looks at him and tilts her head and says, "You are acting very much like Father now."
No idea what you're talking about.
Sweet Kick is actually going to start dancing with Knuckles.
Hello, my baby. Hello, my honey.
Clap, clap.
All right. Well, this has turned into an outright show now. Music in the park.
Yeah. Ponies.
Yeah, so that's how Ballers Take Manhattan got its musical episode.
Do you sing about lemonade?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, this is going to be fun.
No, it's not, because I'm not going to come up with lyrics right now. Or a melody. Although, someone might later.
I'm tempted to do it right now.
Wait, what are we doing? Just drinking fun?
Apparently, there's a musical going on in the park.
I'm okay with this.
Yes, an MLP-style musical number about lemonade.
When life gives you lemons, you make lemonade. All freshly squeezed. All freshly made.
It's sweet and tasty. Cools you oft in the heat.
Monitor actually hits her music box and starts providing some more background music.
Aurelia has gone from looking excited to actually very thoroughly embarrassed.
Stop.
Sweet cake.
Damn ponies ruining everything with their musical numbers.
Why does this always happen with you ponies?
This is normal for ponies.
That's what's messed up about it.
You saying dragons don't spontaneously burst into song? Why not?
Many reasons, I imagine.
She looks genuinely concerned. Are you tone deaf?
No.
Yes.
Again, you only can't think of another reason.
Because singing is kind of lame.
And there she is just a... kind of...
for the crowd. I didn't mean that. Please buy more lemonade. I didn't mean that.
And Monitor actually puts a gentle hoof around her shoulders and says, song is difficult for those who know not singing of heart.
Stop touching me.
And she actually retracts her hoof.
Thank you. By this point, the show, your musical number for which Aurelia's rant provided a kind of small, spoken interlude. You have one more chorus, and then the musical number dies down. anyway, the crowd starts to go away, and Aurelia starts counting her money. Now that the bulk of the sales have happened, and she seems kind of pleased with the amount now. It's like,
is there any lemonade? Is there any of it left?
There's still a bit of it left. Yeah, there is a safe amount of lemonade left to make many more sales.
So, Aurelia.
Yeah.
Before I buy a cop from you, can I get a promise that the next time I see you, it's not going to be in a situation where you're being a troublemaker?
Am I being a troublemaker in this situation?
No. You're doing a very good job at not being a troublemaker.
Hold on.
Why was a troublemaker back at the demolition site?
Sweetcake actually puts her hoof up and says, Mr. Knuckles, you're getting confused. It's me and my friends that are the troublemakers, not Aurelia.
Yeah, I only helped out when it became a problem in those antics. I stayed in line.
She's very respectable and boring. I mean, responsible.
Yeah, hey.
She just kind of grins at you sheepishly.
All right, it is quite possible. You're just a matter of hanging around with the wrong people. Bad influences.
Well, she actually doesn't want to be friends with us. So.
Next time I see you.
I can't think of a reason why I would.
He points at Sweetcake when he says that. Okay.
Sorry, what did he say while pointing at Sweetcake?
Can I count on you to stay out of trouble next time I see you?
I'll do my very best, officer.
You promise?
I promise to do my very best.
That's a good little filly. And he gives Sweetcake a little pat on the head.
She just smiles.
And then Brass Knuckles will pay for a glass of lemonade.
All right. You get yourself a glass of ice-cold lemonade.
And he will enjoy drinking it.
You enjoy drinking it.
And then when it's all gone, he will stick the cup on his horn with all the others.
Aurelia just gives you a very confused look. Just, why? Why do you... Okay, then.
Trophies from his vanquished foes.
I guess.
It's a Minotaur thing.
Alright. By this point it's been like, I don't know, maybe an hour or two? Just some, indistinct amount of time like that.
Oh.
Does Kappa come back?
No, she abandoned you all. yes, Kappa comes back.
Right off.
Kappa comes back, with her saddlebags looking much more notably fuller than when she left, before stepping behind the lemonade stand and emptying out, a sack of lemons, two bags of sugar, some containers of, bottled water, and two, magically heating pitchers.
Oh.
Before smiling and going, well, with these, you should be able to super saturate the sugar into the water so you can make even sweeter lemonade.
Aurelia kind of sticks her tongue out and says, it's already pretty sweet already. But okay, I guess if ponies like that.
If their thing is too sweet.
Maybe not for ponies.
Wait, did you just have this all lying at home, Miss Sunshine?
She kind of eyes the lemons as if going, how many adult drinks do you drink?
she is going to, Kappa is going to cough nervously before going, so can I get that lemonade now?
Yeah, sure. She pours you a cup of the lemonade that, was, already made up, and yeah.
Well, given the kind of kids she has to teach.
Then Kappa is going to, take the lemonade, sit off a little ways to the stand, and pull out a book again. Still in Draconic, notably a textbook this time.
I had canoned it that it's the same book, she just put a different cover over it.
Quite possibly, but and as she pulls out the book, a receipt for the lemons and the sugar and all that falls onto the ground.
Should we roll perception to catch that?
No, it's pretty plain to see.
Sweetcake is going to flutter over, pick up the receipt, and without looking at it, hoof it back over. You know, Miss Sunshine, you're a real nice pony.
Kappa Sunshine is going to blush, look at the receipt, blush, take it a little more quickly than intended, before putting it back into her saddlebag and going, hey, it's nothing. It's nothing for my students.
Then she kind of leans in and whispers, no. Since you are helping your students, maybe you can claim it back on expenses. And then flutters away.
Kappa is just going to...
Teachers get like, expense accounts?
Kappa is going to very notably frown at that comment. Before muttering, well, it's just another thing I have. Just another thing to try with the tax offices this year.
We don't have the pony known as Death in this universe. We do have the pony known as Taxes.
He's in Canterlot.
He's a jerk.
And yet, and
always watching.
Job has nothing to do with finances or money at all.
No, Taxes owns a donut shop.
Everyone loves Taxes.
Donuts and Taxes. There's only two things are certain.
His brother runs a mortuary.
I think we already established that's not in this particular universe.
Taxes.
No, oh, I didn't yep, say that, his brother was there. Called Death. He go. Just runs a mortuary. His brother's actually called Bright Smile.
Anyway. So...
We...
I don't... Anyway. I've said anyway a lot in this session.
It's been kind of a...
All over the
very
place.
Very relaxed. It's been relaxed and all over the place, but that's good sometimes.
Yep.
I know. We've had a driving plot, somewhat.
Lemons.
But like, yeah, lemons. There we go. Business. Listen to Dally. She knows all.
What? Okay. Hear me and obey. What?
After a few minutes of actually reading, Kappa's gonna look up at Aurelia a bit confused and go, actually, I forgot to ask, why exactly did you set up a lemonade stand?
Well, I had a expensive errand. I needed to run and I needed a little bit of extra cash. Most of my paycheck from the literary agency goes towards the, you know, home expenses, so I needed a little extra. And I heard this might be a good way to do that. And to be fair, it's actually been pretty all right.
Kappa is going to smile at that and then go, well, forgive me if I'm prying a little bit, but may I ask what and to who?
That's kind of personal.
Okay. And she'll just smile and go back to reading her book.
Brass Knuckles, meanwhile, will give a nod of the hat and say, all right, well, you kids, behave, and I wish you the best with your lemonade stand.
All right.
And then he will proceed on.
All right.
Sweetcake waves him off, then turns and mutters to the kids, notably not to the adults, but to the kids. What's the betting he's going to be my parole officer one day?
I would like to make a roll to hear that.
You may roll perception.
You know what? All perception for that one.
I want to make a roll to hear that as well.
You've already walked off.
Okay, fair enough.
Yeah, I think she would have waited until you were out of earshot, I'm afraid.
A 28.
Both Zenkarn and Kappa hear that.
Kappa will just kind of turn to Zenkarn and give a knowing look and then giggle.
I'll, yeah. I'll just give a quick glance over it, over all the children, and be like, yeah, well, you might not be the only one.
Alright. Officer Brass Knuckles, you notice as you continue on your trek through the park that there is a crowd of similar size on the other side of the park, of similar size to the one you'd gathered on your side of the park.
He will head over in that direction to just to check it out.
And you notice that there are a bunch of ponies gathered around a table, seated at which seem to be three more dragons, young dragons.
Are they doing anything in particular?
They seem to have set up a lemonade stand.
Are they young dragons like Aurelia?
They seem to be a little bit older, a little bit taller. Ah. And they are putting on more of a spectacle with their lemonade stand. They also seem to have bought a bunch of lemons and sugar and water to make it themselves. But they're using these big, showy emotions to mix it all together and gouts of fire to superheat the water when they mix in the sugar and the lemon juice. And they're also selling it for one bit a cup.
Does it look like they're being dangerous, or?
They do look like they're being far more reckless than Aurelia's little group was.
Are they just people around, or is there a line?
Some are around, some are in line waiting for the next cups to be available.
Yeah, I'm going to make a perception check towards, or would it be perception or insight?
To discern what?
I guess just get a general better sense of what's going on, like if there's something that's, I mean, especially with the more reckless, just to make sure that, you know, there's no signs that there's something fishy afoot.
Insight.
Okay, then. I got a 17.
To make sure it's all good. It looks like there might be a bit of a hazard, but the dragons don't look like they're out to really harm any pony today. But it does look like they are motivated by something a bit sort of mean-spirited or nefarious, but not towards any of these ponies.
Would it be, can I make another roll to see what if they're got an aim like that, or would that?
You notice that their stand seems to be, like, as far as, like, the table they're using, the design of their sign, and even, like, the setup of their arrangement process seems to be suspiciously similar to how Aurelia has set it up.
Well, hello there,
he will say as he heads toward, so he's in the crowd, but I'm guessing they're all ponies, so he's going to stand above it regardless.
All right. Slightly tallest and central dragon, this silver and blue drake, just kind of smirks up you and says, oh, hello, officer. Want a cup of ice cold lemonade? It's only one bit a cup.
Well, that's a pretty impressive price for lemonade.
Yeah, we're feeling generous today.
Really?
Yeah, it's very hot for you ponies and minotaurs and other out here, right? Why not have a cup of ice cold lemonade? Although, she kind of squints up at your horns and says, I guess you've already had some today. Well, you know, it's only one bit, right?
He will nod. He'll subtly glance in the direction of Aurelia's lemonade stand. Not in a way that's meant to be accusatory, but trying to hint that he suspects there's something going on here.
You notice that her eyes also subtly go in that direction, but before long they're back, you know, facing you with a pleasant smile on her face.
I suppose I could take a glass?
Sure. That'll be one bit.
He will look each of them in the eye as he slowly and deliberately places the one bit on the table, letting them know that he's keeping his eyes on them and that they better not be up to any mischief that he would not like to know that they're... I'm putting way too many words into that.
Yeah, basically, you try and make a subtle gesture along those lines, but, you know, the dragons in front of you, they keep their... they remain pleasant as they take your money and pour you a glass of lemonade.
He will take it, he will nod, and he will first taste it to...
It is actually perfectly fine lemonade. Just as cold, just as tasty as any other you've had today, apparently.
He will drink it, and once he's finished with it, he will add it to his collection.
At this, the silver dragoness does look a bit weirded out as you add the cup to your collection on your horns.
So funny seeing you have this set up here. Couldn't...
What about it?
I don't suppose you know the dragon on the other side, do you?
Oh, but is there another dragon in the park? We don't see a whole lot of us outside of Dragon Town, is the thing.
Can I make a roll to see if they're faking this and if they...
You may absolutely roll insight.
That insight or perception?
Insight.
Okay. Okay. Yeah, I'll just... Yeah, it looks like a 20 on that.
You can basically tell by her subtle eye movements and her occasional glances that, yeah, she's absolutely aware that Aurelia has set up a lemonade stand on pretty much the exact opposite end of the park.
Is any sign that she knows Aurelia, that she's lying about knowing her?
Considering how convenient this all is, it's very likely.
You sure you don't know the dragon on the other side?
She gives you a brief hard look and then shrugs and says, maybe I do. What's the problem? Is there a problem, officer? Am I doing anything illegal?
No, you're not doing anything illegal.
All right, well, I guess we'll keep on selling our lemonade. For a very, very cheap price.
So I take it you're a pretty generous group of dragons, then.
Oh, yeah.
That's a pretty uncommon trait for dragons.
Well, for dragons from the Badlands, maybe, but, you know, for city dragons, it's not unheard of, right? It's actually kind of ungrateful, really, for ponies and minotaurs and all that to think the dragons are all fire all the time.
Well, you're not wrong.
Aren't they using fire to heat up their water?
Say what?
Oh, no, I was just pointing out that they're saying we're not all fire all the time. You are using fire right now.
Yeah, they are actually there. they're using fire to put on a little show and, you know, supercharge the lemonade, basically.
All right, so Brass Knuckles will give them a nod.
Well, have a good day.
And then he will wander around the park the other direction till he circles back to where Aurelia's stand is.
All right. And by this point, the crowd seems to have completely dried up. There's barely been a single sale since Brass Knuckles left. It's just been pretty quiet. But, you know, that's kind of normal, you know. You know, customers come and go. You know, there's dry spells. Unless...
Papa does notably keep refilling her glass every time she finishes it, so.
Yeah, so there's that.
So how has business been?
Aurelia shrugs and says, it's been alright, I guess. Haven't really had any new ponies.
And he will glance in the direction where the other three are set up.
It's kind of a long distance away, the whole length of the park, but Aurelia kind of follows your eyes and says, although there does seem to be a bunch of ponies over there for some reason, I guess that's why they're not over here.
Funny story, there's actually a trio of dragons that have set up a competing stand on the other side of the park.
Aurelia's claws slam on the table and she jumps up and says, what?
Because we can do the somehow, exact same thing in unison.
Somehow they figured out how to sell lemonade for a cup.
Fida. It's probably Mindy and Linda, too.
You know them?
Yeah, they're other dragons in my neighborhood. They don't like me.
and I don't like them.
Yeah, I got the sense they might know you.
Sweet Kid raises an eyebrow. Wait, you don't get on with other dragons either? Who do you get on with?
So those dragons in particular, Fida, she's from a particular lineage that doesn't really like my particular lineage, and there's this whole dumb, you know, rivalry thing that I don't really even care about, but she does a lot, so it's, I mean, it's dumb, but...
It does sound dumb.
It is.
Dumbly dumb.
They're undercutting me, really, on a lemonade stand, really?
One bit of cup.
Can Cuppa roll general knowledge on this?
They're putting on quite a show, yeah. Too.
Just given, you know, dragon stuffs.
Absolutely. What do you want to know specifically about?
Just in general, like, knowledge on the feud. But I suppose I should also first check to see if Cuppa even knows these other dragons.
I'll tell you right. I'll tell you right now. Cuppa probably won't because these dragonesses are not in her classes. They probably don't go to that school.
Okay, but a 25 on general knowledge.
All right, 25 on general knowledge regarding dragons. Dragon feuds between families are not actually terribly uncommon. In the wild dragonlands, you know that there's a couple that are terribly high profile, one between a particular line of, like, gold dragons and one between a line of silver dragons. That's, like, the most commonly known one amongst people who know that there's generally such a thing. Like, that's the one main example they know of.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, with the 25, that's... It's pretty good, but it's also not terribly common knowledge. The fact that you know this is pretty impressive.
Okay. In that case, Cuppa will just kind of go back to reading her book, but listening in to the conversation.
And Aurelia just kind of glares across the way at the crowd of ponies and just mutters, "I was so close too, but they're gonna probably." Probably gonna keep all the ponies away from me as much as they can.
Just because it's some dumb family thing?
Yeah.
Like, nothing you did, just...
Well, I mean, we might have gone back and forth a couple of times.
So you're saying this is kind of a rivalry thing? She gets kind of a mischievous grin on her face.
I don't want ponies getting in on a dragon thing, alright? That's the last thing I need right here.
This isn't a dragon thing, this is just a lemonade thing. It's just business.
Aurelia puts a claw up, then seems like she kind of agrees with your reasoning there. And like, so what do we do then?
Well, the way I see it, we got a couple options. We could even do both. See, on the one hoof, we could up our own game. We can't really lower the price. I mean, we could, but it's, you know, it would take way longer to earn stuff that way. So what we could do is just make ours better. We could garnish the glasses, maybe add one or two extra ingredients. The other thing we could do is, well, maybe go over there and scope out their stall a little bit.
They are putting on quite a show.
If you like, you and I could go over there. Or actually I'll rephrase that. If you like, a few of us could go over there and maybe offer them, a glass of our lemonade and we can have a glass of theirs and just kind of, you know, show that we're being good sports and stuff for now. And then while we're there, we can see what kind of stuff they got going on and how we can do better than them.
All right. I like the way you think, although the moment... Me and Fida see each other, there's gonna be words. Unless...
Would you like there to be words, or would you like that...
She looks deviously at Brass Knuckles. Not if there's an authority figure to disappoint.
Hmm.
Well, I'm just gonna make sure there's no, unlawful shenanigans going on.
Right, so no burning down their lemonade stand. I mean, what?
That would,
Sweet
that
Kid
would
just smiles and goes, "I like this dragon."
I will not allow any burning down of burning down the process of this rivalry. That would be a no-no. Very big
no-no. She just said that's exactly what she's not going to do.
Yeah, that's what I said.
Yeah.
Innocent not always look. What you say so much as how you say it.
Brass knuckles, I'm being serious.
That's good to hear.
Okay. I just need a few more sales to get the money I need. So we just gotta beat them at this game they're playing now. So yeah, let's go see what they're doing.
Sweetcake is going to quickly cut a small, a slice of lemon and kind of place it on one of the plastic cups, like on the edge of it. You know how they kind of do with cocktails? To make it look a bit fancier.
Yeah.
And she pours some lemonade into the cup.
All right.
Well, ready? This looks quite nice, yeah? Something you'd want to drink?
I guess.
She kind of plops one or two more ice cubes in it so it makes a nice jingling noise.
All right.
Ready when you are.
Aurelia looks around at everyone gathered and says, Mort, hold down the fort. I'm going to go scope out the competition real quick. Officer, would you mind coming along?
I was planning on it.
All right. And Aurelia hops down and goes with sweet cake, lemonade in hand.
Brass Knuckles will follow just closely enough behind that he can provide an authority figure to ensure nobody tries any shenanigans.
All right.
But he will still keep a respectful distance.
Okay. Aurelia and Sweetcake, and I suppose anyone else who wants to tag along. Does anyone else want to tag along?
Yeah, I'll go. Should probably keep an eye on the dragon.
Kappa's going to stay with the stand.
All right. You head on over to the other side of the park where the dragonesses are now putting on something akin to a fireworks display over their stand to make the ponies go ooh and ah as they...
Is that something that, I mean, are they doing it in a way that would be illegal?
The fire seems to not be combusting anything. There may be some magic involved on that. But so, they also might be kind of skirting with public decency laws.
Oh, I was muted. Okay.
Yeah.
Can I make a roll to find out whether what they're doing?
Yeah, okay, Monitor is there too, I guess.
Okay.
Does she roll will to not have a panic attack at this fire?
Oh, yeah, you'd have... If that's a problem, then yeah, you'd want to roll will for that.
Alright. I have rolled nothing.
Yeah, you gotta put on the code. Oh, well, that's actually a very,
okay,
very strong exertion of will, and your monitor is able to keep it together even as the dragon set off these fantastic fiery displays above their stand.
Right.
Can I make a roll to make sure they're not doing anything that would give Brass
sure.
Knuckle?
Sure, you can make a roll.
So that's what, general knowledge or insight?
General knowledge. Exception.
Okay. I roll a 12.
You think maybe if someone's filed a noise complaint, maybe you could get them on something. At the very least, you could probably just give them a warning to tone it down a bit, but nothing really seems to be actually illegal here.
All right, then he will continue to keep a respectful distance on the matter.
All right, Aurelia and Sweetcake go up to the... basically push through the throng of ponies, lemonade in hand, and Fida and Aurelia make eye contact, and they both make an effort to keep on friendly smiles as they just kind of grind their teeth at each other. It's like, hello, Fida. Hello, Aurelia. What brings you
monitor in the background going, it's that predatory smile again.
Yeah.
Indeed, yeah. You can definitely tell with Fida.
Aurelia, you gonna introduce us?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Hey, everypony. I'm Aurelia, and just want to let you guys know that we also have a lemonade stand. Some of you have already been there, I guess, over on the other side of the park, and...
We wanted to come over and, you know, say hi to the other lemonade stand.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hello. Hello. The three dragonesses on the other side of the table just kind of try to keep on their best face, but their eyes just seem to be kind of glaring as hard as they can at you.
In the spirit of healthy competition, we brought one of our drinks for you.
Oh, well, thank you, and I guess you'd like us to make you a drink of ours as well?
Oh, gosh, you could if you wanted to. That'll be lovely. Innocent drink.
One of the dragonesses next to Fida says, why would we want to? And then she gets an elbow to the side. Says, we'd love to, in the spirit of healthy competition, right? Wouldn't want to look bad since you're being so generous, right?
Of course.
Of course. They pour out a glass of lemonade and they push it across the table for you.
Is Aurelia going to take it, or?
Aurelia seems Aurelia kind of hesitates to do so.
In which case, Sweet Cake will take it.
Shit.
Sorry? Sorry, did someone say something?
Yeah. Yes, Brass Knuckles said, hooray for the spirit of healthy competition!
Sweet Cake is going to pick up the glass of lemonade they proffer.
Alright, and
she kind of holds it up as if to cheers.
And Fida holds up the one you guys offered.
And she will start taking quite a long sip from the glass cup thing.
Alright, and same thing happens, and you notice too, it's, you know, it's lemonade, it's about the same, maybe a little bit warmer than yours. The fire treatments definitely had an effect, although it seemed to be a little bit sweeter in trade.
Oh boy, they know how I like it. Is Fida drinking the cup we gave her?
Yep, yes she is.
As soon as Flotsam sees, Flotsam is actually going to wait for Fida to put the cup, like, finish taking a sip before she finishes her sip, if that makes any sense.
Alright, yeah, she finishes.
After waiting a beat to see how she reacts, Sweet Cake will also put the cup down.
A kind of tense silence rolls in out of nowhere, and the ponies around you seem to kind of be holding their breath without realizing it, as they subconsciously sense that there's something bigger going on here.
Then a few notes of tense dramatic background music will play just briefly.
God damn it, Knuckles, for the way of the ukulele.
Monitor just gives Knuckles a look.
Sweet Cake is going to go kind of like, real tasty.
Fida just kind of grimaces at you and looks dismissively at the cup of lemonade you offered them, and she says, yeah, that was all right.
With an air of slight patronizing and slight condescension, she's going to continue. I mean, you guys must have worked really hard on this. I can tell. You put a lot of work into it, didn't you? And giving it away for only one bit. I mean, gosh, that sure is generous of you. You know, lemonade this lovely.
Yep. Shame not every pony can sell lemonade as great as ours for the price we sell it at, huh?
Yeah, too bad. I sure wish we could make lemonade like yours. Unfortunately, we make ours colder.
Is that so? I suppose the dragon you've got can't quite breathe as much fire as Norelli just growls at them.
Well, to be fair, we've only got one dragon, and you guys have three.
Although at the mention of colder, some of the ponies in the crowd go, colder, huh? It's kind of hot out, especially standing near all this fire. The dragonesses don't seem to notice, and they just like, anyway, was that it? Was that all you wanted to do? I think we both got lemonade to sell, don't we?
Yeah, we should probably get back to ours. We don't want it all running out before it's all, you know.
Yeah. Have fun.
You too.
Alright. And Aurelia just tries her best not to look like she's stomping off, but she stomps off back towards the lemonade stand.
Sweet Cake is going to do the Pinkie Pie bounce to make it seem more natural.
Sure, because that looks extremely natural.
Yes. Anything looks natural next to the Pinkie Pie bounce.
All right. So you and Aurelia and Zenkarn and Brass Knuckles head on back towards the other side of the park, where looks like Mort's actually kind of attracted a couple more customers.
Hey, Mort, good job!
Yeah, just, you know, waved some ponies down like, you know, Monitor said to.
Look at you, learning. You might get your cutie mark.
Okay, sure, yeah. That'd be nice. Aurelia just kind of grumbles and goes, all right, back to me, I guess.
Hey, you did good, by the way. I would have socked her one.
There will be time for that later.
Well, I probably wouldn't have socked her one while everyone was looking.
Huh?
Or at all, because that would be wrong, she adds, remembering that there are adults present.
Someone being a not nice person is not a good reason to sock a one.
Yes, you're right. I'm sorry.
Aurelia just kind of gets back up on her stool and just grumbles to herself. Looks like her
Monitor actually has a confused look on her face and says, what would dragons be of needing with socks?
It means punch her in the face. That's what we meant, Monitor.
Oh.
I like this pony. She has a literal mind.
By this, the encounter with her rivals, I suppose, has brought Aurelia's mood back down. And as she sits there behind the counter with her lemonade, it seems like her mood is driving some other prospective customers away, like it was before.
Brass Knuckles will try to play a song to bring up her spirits.
Why does he think? No, oh god.
Aurelia is not encouraged by your lyrical inclinations, because as stated before, she does not get this whole tradition of musical numbers.
Not with words, just music notes, tune. So that probably doesn't make a difference.
It really doesn't, though.
Flotsam will... Sorry, Sweetcake will give Aurelia a concerned look. Hey, your grump's showing.
I know. It's just that there's not really a whole lot more we can do, right? I mean, I was nice. I reduced the price. We went to a better location. Even started making it ourselves, and... Oh, goodness.
Yeah, look, you did real good, see?
And if she I had, to, if I had to actually, if I reimbursed all of you, it probably just, she looks at the money cup, I'd probably just lose everything I made.
Yeah, but those were donations. Mm. You don't gotta reimburse us.
Aurelia starts counting the money again for a bit, then grumbles to herself and then pushes it away. Says, I don't deserve this.
What? But this was all your idea, right?
Yeah, but I didn't actually do any of it. I didn't... Well,
sure you did. You squeezed one of the lemons. You squeezed some of the lemons. You heated up the water. You made nice. You. I mean, that must have taken effort, right? Like, did you pull a muscle?
Against her inclination, she smiles a little bit at that. Smirks a little bit, rather, at the joke. But she says, I didn't do this myself, though. It wasn't my, you know, strength or smarts or anything like that. It was mostly you guys.
Yeah, Aurelia, about that. Why do you think we're helping you?
I don't know. Because you wanted to sell lemonade today? Because you thought it'd be fun?
Because we like you. You did that. You're a pretty cool dragon. I mean, you're really grouchy sometimes, but... I don't know. Mm. I know you don't want to be friends with me, but I still like hanging out with you. You're fun.
She looks around at the rest of the group and says, what about the rest of you? You just want to be nice too?
Be nice?
You're just being nice?
I work with you, and helping you out's always fun.
Well, yeah, I mean, yeah, I appreciate your help, Zenkarn. But, you know.
So, what?
Help me out with the stuff out of work so much.
Gotta do something with my time.
So you're bored, huh?
That and this seemed important to you, so
you know.
Sweet Cake folds her front legs and kind of fixes Aurelia with a scrutinizing look. So, I just told you that I like hanging out with you, and you think that this is just me trying to be nice, like I'm being some kind of charitable or something? You do realize I don't do that, right? What do you take me for?
Aurelia, not really sure what to think at this point, but she just kind of grumbles and picks up one of the money cups and says, sure you don't want to share this? Because that's what I was going to say. You guys earned this more than I did.
Yeah, but we don't gotta earn stuff for something like you do. This is like a fundraiser. Yeah? Like, not for a charity or stuff, because obviously, you know, you're a dragon, not a charity. But it's going to a good cause, right? Look, I don't need money for stuff. I think I may have mentioned that my dad's a council pony. We're not exactly hurting for cash. So...
All right. Thank you, guys, I guess.
You guess?
I guess. Thank you.
Close enough.
Sweet Cake actually kind of puts her hooves over where her heart is and kind of goes, and collapses. The shock. It has killed me.
Now is not the time to patronize me, Sweet Cake.
This is a perfect time to patronize you. Like, patrons, buying your lemonade. Get it?
That was awful.
That was bad, even for you, small child.
You don't know me that well. You don't know what I'm capable of.
Hopefully not worse than that.
Kappa's just going to grimace and go, no, trust me, she's capable of much, much worse.
Big, big grin.
Yeah, okay. No wonder. All right. No wonder you wanted something a little bit stronger that day.
So... after this, Aurelia's mood, kind of against her own will, lightens considerably after that. She stops focusing on the downers so much. And her mood is enough to attract a few more customers and sell a few more cups of ice-cold lemonade. And then after a few more customers come and go, the second money cup is filled, third one is set aside.
Well, as this is going on, Brass Knuckles will give a nod. And it looks like my job here is done. Have a good day. And he will nod and he will continue on his way yet again.
All right.
And as he goes, he will play a few bars from a mix of the earlier Lemonade song mixed with whatever, with some kind of commonly recognized friendship song.
All right. And...
Actually, Monitor just stares after him and says, is he thinking he is some sort of traveling heroine? And then she blinks and blushes and covers her box awkwardly and says, hero, person.
Anyway.
Hot box is very bad words.
You should get your dad to take a look at that.
As the sun that had been beating down all day starts to cast shadows from the trees and buildings, as it starts to set, Aurelia counts up all the bits she's collected from her sales and gasps as she counts past 90 and says, that's it! That's enough! I got it!
Well, awesome! Hey, up top! Yeah. She holds out her hoof.
Yeah, she high-fives you unironically and then kind of blushes as she realizes that that's not what she wanted. That doesn't fit with her image at all, and she just kind of like, yeah, whatever. You know, tries to brush it off.
She just grins and sidles over to Mort and says, sorry, probably should have let you do that.
Mort just blushes and Aurelia continues to ignore his existence at this point.
Yeah. You have fulfilled your usefulness.
And Aurelia kind of looks up at Kappa and says, you wanted to know why, right?
Yeah, I mean, you don't have to.
Well, I mean, you guys did help out. I figure you deserve to know.
Woo! Information! My favorite.
Aurelia starts reaching into the cooler, into her bag of snacks, and says, Zenkarn, remember that divorcee client we had?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that was...
You know, the rich one?
Entertaining. Yeah.
Well...
What about her?
She, after we got... After we... The payment cleared for that, she actually mailed me a gift.
Are we allowed to accept those?
I don't know,
I don't remember the rules on that.
I don't know, but she apparently didn't want this. She, you know, thought it was some kind of letting go thing, which fit in with the narrative of her story she tried to sell, so, you know. She pulls out a box and opens it up, and there is a, you know, hoof ring with a big old diamond set in it.
I can see why you kept that with your snacks.
Well, I'm gonna mail this back home. I'm gonna send it back to my Uncle Glaurung, so he can put it in his hoard or something.
You're not gonna start your own hoard?
Me and my uncle didn't. When I left, we didn't really part on good terms.
Oh.
And, you know, kind of want to mend fences or build bridges or whatever the pony phrase is for it. So yeah, thanks, guys.
Oh, Kappa is just going to smile at that.
So, you guys gonna help me clean up too?
Is that? Oh is man, that, I that... don't know about. Yeah, sure.
Is that part of this whole friends thing?
Yeah, you know, you're lucky I don't like hugs, or you'd be getting one right now.
Oh, there's a thing you don't like? Shocking.
Kappa's going to grin and go, well, clearly that's your blackmail, then. All you have to do is hug her to get back at her.
Yeah, no, that's not happening. That's never happening.
Cakes doesn't like hugs? Gas!
I know, right?
Alright. And with your help, Aurelia packs up the table and all the lemonade into the cooler. You can divvy up the remaining lemons and sugar and water amongst yourselves, the ones who, you know, actually purchased those things. And as a group, you walk back to Dragontown. Just kind of, I suppose, chatting along the way.
Yay.
Or, you know, whoever's family was already in the park, you know, you say your goodbyes there, or, you know, you basically part ways there. And I think that does it for this session of Mawlers Take Manehattan.
Yay!
I think.
That was super nice and low-key.
No, yeah. It was good.
You know, for such a simple concept, it worked out surprisingly well.
I thought it would.
Yeah, that was good. There were lots of different things we could actually do with that. Yeah,
and
good ones.
I feel so thrilled that even though it was mostly described, we actually got a musical number.
Yep.
Frickin'
I actually had a tune in mind, but when I opened my mouth, a tune did not come out.
I'm not gonna lie, I was really hoping I could have Kappa come back and just spout off some random fact about dragons as far as singing was concerned, but I couldn't come up with anything in time.
Yeah, it turns out making songs is hard.
Mm-hmm.
That's why we don't actually do it.
Yep.
Alright, I need people to do the close off, because it's not actually going to be me this time, because I was the DM again.
Sure not was. It.
Well, are we going to decide first who's doing it next week? Or
someone needs to commit to it.
I can definitely do next week's session.
So, go.
Alright, well, go.
Unless
Jawa, you really want to do yours.
Well, if I committed to it, that'd probably give me good reason to actually put it together.
Well, do you want us to give you that challenge then? Do you want us to hold you to that?
You know what? Yes. Let's do that.
All right.
Yeah, so how about I do the second part then? So
all right.
Okay. Join us next time on Mawlers Take Manehattan.
Wait, no,
has been.
Oh, yeah, right.
Yeah.
This has been Mawlers Take Manehattan.
Join us next time when we take a trip to the zoo.